Lake Charles. At your service with news for Southwest Louisiana. This is 7 News Live at 5.
It's unjustified. It's unjustifiable. The violence, the hatred just has to stop.
Governor John Bel Edwards speaking this afternoon at a news conference on the Baton Rouge law enforcement shooting. Good afternoon, I'm Erica Bivens. The city of Baton Rouge still healing from a recent high-profile police-involved shooting, now forced to deal with another tragic event. Three officers gunned down this morning, several more injured. Jeremy Roth reports.
The sound of gunshots rang through the streets of Baton Rouge Sunday morning. An apparent attack on police officers.
One suspect is deceased. Multiple officers were shot. We do have some that have been killed.
Authorities say six officers were shot, three later died. Heavy police presence outside the hospital where some of the surviving officers are now being treated. Louisiana Governor John Bel Edwards spoke out after visiting with victims' families.
It's unjustified. It's unjustifiable. The violence, the hatred just has to stop.
Authorities advise residents of surrounding homes and businesses to stay indoors.
We're on lockdown at the moment. Everyone is in a bed. We cannot leave. And even if we could leave, the police are blocking down the street. So everyone has to stay where we are.
Threats against officers have been a concern for the Baton Rouge Police Department since the death of Alton Sterling earlier this month and other recent police-involved shootings. Sterling was shot and killed by police outside a convenience store following a violent encounter with officers. The next day in Minnesota, Philando Castile was shot and killed by a police officer during a traffic stop. And following both shootings, five Dallas police officers were killed by a sniper during a police brutality protest. I'm Jeremy Roth reporting.
Well, a woman heading to church this morning with her family actually captured some of those frightening moments on cell phone video. Jada Gabriel says they were sitting at a red light when they heard something that sounded like a pop. She says it was terrifying. Gabriel says police officers were trying to get drivers to turn around. You can see one officer there ducking behind a patrol car. Gabriel says she didn't see a shooter, only several police cars. And CNN and MSNBC now identifying the shooter in today's killing of officers in Baton Rouge as 29-year-old Gavin Long of Kansas City, Missouri. Authorities believe the person who shot and killed their officers was the suspect shot and killed at the scene. However, they're still searching for two other individuals. The investigation continues as they search for a possible motive. In the meantime, several law enforcement agencies and city officials spoke out against the senseless shooting this afternoon as well. Mayor Kip Holden calling for peace.
We are one family, all seeking justice for all of our people. And so let me thank the president and also Ms. Jarrett for their calls, and the governor will elaborate on the call he got also from the president.
And President Obama also taking a moment late this afternoon to address the shooting.
We don't need inflammatory rhetoric. We don't need careless accusations thrown around to score political points or to advance an agenda. We need to temper our words and open our hearts, all of us.
Back here at home, Sheriff Tony Mancuso also released a statement today on the recent shootings in Baton Rouge saying, quote, "We at the Calcasieu Parish Sheriff's Office are praying for the families of the fallen officers and the entire Baton Rouge community. I am also concerned for our deputies. We will still get up every day and come to work to protect our community, but the safety of our deputies is imperative to me, so I'm calling on our community to continue their partnership with law enforcement so we can all stay safe." He goes on to say, "Let's all please have a talk with their children and grandchildren and teach them to respect and comply with authority. I can assure you, if everyone shows respect and complies with law enforcement officers, no one will get hurt." He concluded by saying, "This is a heartbreaking but worrisome time for law enforcement and their families. Please pray for us and our safety." We'll, of course, continue to bring you any new information as it develops here on air and online at kplctv.com, as well as your 7 News mobile app. Well, in other news, there was a big welcome home this morning for members of the armed forces here in Lake Charles. KPLC's Caitlin Rust has more from the National Guard Armory on how veterans showed their appreciation for those who serve.
What better way to be welcomed home than with some watermelon and some pizza? The Louisiana National Guard 3rd Battalion of the 156th Infantry came back to the Armory here in Lake Charles this morning after a long weekend at Camp Beauregard. The Vinton VFW Post, Sulphur and Vinton Armed Forces Committees, and the Vietnam Veterans of America made this possible for around 100 men and women. Veterans and other members of the community served fresh watermelon, pizza, and drinks in order to show them how much they care.
I'd like to thank the community for all the things that they do for us, and know that it really does mean a lot to us.
Later on 7 News Nightcast, I'll have more on why these veterans want to make our armed forces feel so loved.
At your service in Lake Charles, Caitlin Riss, KPLC 7 News. And still to come, Cleveland is getting ready for the Republican National Convention. The story right after this.
Decorated Olympian of all time is back in the water and doing what he does best, winning. In the 100-meter butterfly, he had the fastest time in the world this year. In the 200-meter individual medley, he had the fastest time in the world this year. And in the 200-meter butterfly, the fastest time in the world this year. He's back and aiming for Rio. The Olympics, this August on NBC.
Just announced, Chevrolet is again the number one domestic brand for quality by J.D. Power. Better than Ford, better than Dodge, better than any domestic brand. Chevy is number one, and your Lake Charles area Chevy dealers are celebrating by saving you money. Save 20% off MSRP on a great selection of new Chevrolets. That's right, save 20% off MSRP on the number one cars, trucks, and SUVs for quality. So for the highest quality domestic cars, trucks, and SUVs, come to your Lake Charles area Chevy dealers.
I started in 1972 working for a local refinery. We would go pick the asbestos up after fires. We weren't taught how to do it, so we were picking it up dry. We'd just dust ourselves off with an air hose, which blew it right in our face. I'd been worried a little bit about my breathing problem. The latency period, the time from exposure, the time I have symptoms, was just about right, 30, 35 years. Knowing what I do know about asbestos, it's time to get a check.
Call 855-397-3997 today.
If you've been considering physical therapy for your recovery options, XL Therapy in Moss Bluff is a therapy team you can trust. At XL Therapy, our therapists understand how to maximize your treatment options.
XL Therapy is the team that I trust on the road to recovery.
Get the experience of therapist Shannon Johnson and his team at XL Therapy in Moss Bluff. XL Therapy Group, for physical and occupational therapy that's right for you.
We call it Southwest Louisiana. Sportsman's paradise. Cajun country. Well, the names may be up for debate, but whether you're from West Calcasieu, East Beauregard, or the Cameron Coast, everyone agrees. Our proud traditions make us a certain way. It's the way we embrace our faith, community, and our heritage. That way is what unites us. It's what we call home.
Downtown Cleveland looks and sounds very different from usual as the city prepares to host the Republican National Convention. Reporter Carly Flynn took a tour of downtown Cleveland and talked to locals and visitors about all the excitement.
Plenty of people took advantage of the great weather and spent the afternoon outside on East 4th. Although this week they're surrounded by the national media in town for the RNC. It's just one difference in a city full of changes.
I'm very happy to see what the city has done. I think that they're very well prepared.
Wendy Meister lives and works downtown. She says she didn't expect as many barriers, but she's glad to see them.
I feel very safe. I'm excited to live down here.
But many people aren't looking forward to commuting down here. Barricades and fencing block many roads and intersections, creating a traffic snarl block after block. And here's something you don't generally see in July. Snow plows acting as blockades here in Public Square.
Even visitors notice all the safety measures.
There are officers at every corner. There's National Guard called out, and it looks like it's a tight security control. There are helicopters that are intimidating, circling all over the place.
You'll hear the whirl of several helicopters overhead throughout the day.
I'm sure everybody feels really confident and comfortable here. That's the most important thing.
Clevelanders like Wendy Meister staying optimistic for the days ahead.
I think it's all going to be good. I have my fingers crossed that everything turns out well.
Cleveland's police chief says it's game time and we're ready. This morning, Cleveland's mayor and police chief updated reporters on preparations for the Republican National Convention, which begins tomorrow. The chief says hundreds of agencies and thousands of law officers are in town. All out-of-state officers have been sworn in, so they have the same responsibilities as Cleveland officers. Police Chief Calvin Williams says all officers have been briefed on Ohio's open carry law and how to properly handle someone expressing their right to carry a weapon openly. The chief also said gun owners have the responsibility to carry their weapons in a way that's not threatening. The chief says they've had protests in the city for 8 days already, all peaceful, and they're not anticipating any problems, but they are prepared for anything. Turning to national news, Turkish citizens and journalists take to live streaming via Twitter's Periscope and Facebook Live to show the world in real time dramatic video of the military uprising. Samuel Burke reports.
The revolution will not be tweeted. That's how it was looking in the first hour of the attempted coup in Turkey Friday night. Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube all slowing to a crawl. Twitter's global public policy team tweeting, "We have no reason to think we've been fully blocked in Turkey, but we suspect there is an intentional slowing of our traffic in country." Throttling the internet instead of outright blocking it has become the government's preferred method of manipulating social media, according to experts. But just 1 hour after connectivity was at a virtual standstill, social media came roaring back to life in Turkey. The country's president turned to Apple's FaceTime to communicate with the country. Apparently unable to access TV studios, sister network CNN Turk had to interview Erdogan holding up an iPhone using the video chat feature just after midnight local time. It wasn't clear where the president was speaking from. With the connection back, Turkish citizens and journalists turned to live streaming via Twitter's Periscope and Facebook Live to show the world in real time dramatic video of the military uprising. Even capturing low-flying jets zooming over the capital city of Ankara. Turkey is the second most active country on Periscope in the world. Turks moved quickly to get their photos and messages out on social media, not knowing when the next digital blackout might come. The Turkish government has one of the most fraught relationships with social media worldwide. YouTube was blocked more than 2 years there, beginning in 2008. Social media was slowed down in the hours after the recent Istanbul airport attacks, as well as multiple times just before the country's held elections. Now Erdogan is taking to social media himself, tweeting out, "We have put our heads at risk for the sake of this noble cause. This attempted coup will be repelled with God's permission." One of the top trending hashtags in the country Saturday translates to, "I want the death penalty." The hashtag spreading after Turkey's prime minister mentioning that there's no death penalty in the Turkish legal system, but making clear parliament will now discuss what measures should be taken to prevent another coup in the night. Samuel Burke, CNN, London.
You know, sometimes we take technology for granted, but we use it for not only news, but weather, too.
Oh, we definitely use it in weather. We have these big computer models that tells us or tries to tell us what the weather's going to be like. And we also have a thing called radar, which was a bit active today because we did have more of those kind of scattered storms. Not everybody got wet, but some of you did get a downpour. How's your work week forecast looking? I'll have that coming up after the break.
Sarah got another promotion at work.
I could care less.
You mean couldn't care less?
That's what I said.
No, you said could care less.
Same thing.
Could care less means you still care a little.
But I don't.
Exactly. Couldn't care less.
Get into and out of life's tight spaces with the 2016 RAV4 with bird's eye view camera. Right now, qualified buyers get 0% APR for 60 months, or qualified lessees can lease the adventurous 2016 RAV4 LE for only $199 a month. Toyota, let's go places.
I'm amazed at the natural beauty here. I don't want to miss a single day.
And thanks to Lake Area Medical Center, I don't have to.
Not long ago, I felt a pain in my chest and my arms. I got to the ER just in time.
It was a heart attack. They cleared my artery and they saved my life. If you have even the slightest thought that you might be having a heart attack, get help fast. Each sunset is even more precious now.
Nestled under the historic Salier Oak, the Imperial Calcasieu Museum preserves our rich past and explores the future of visual art. Step back in time as you discover centuries of Imperial Calcasieu history. Then step into the Gibson Barham Gallery to experience the diverse works of contemporary and traditional artists. Branch Out Summer Arts Camp explores surrealism through drawing, painting, printmaking, and sculpture. Arts education and cultural preservation, the Imperial Calcasieu Museum.
There are jobs, and then there are careers that are fulfilling. Careers that give you the opportunity to innovate, to be the technology leaders, while working with creative minds. The chance to share success with others and make an impact on your part of the world. At Raycom Media, we're looking now for people who want more than a job. People like you. Go to RayconMedia.com and click on Careers.
The new weather app from 7 News. New features, a whole new level of keeping your family safe. The power and precision of the 7 Storm Team, plus the customization you want. Now with pinpoint radar accuracy, targeted warnings where you live, and the power to alert your family and friends wherever they are. Download the free 7 Storm Team weather app. Text weather app to 33777 or search KPLC in your app store today. From the 7 Storm Team, your first alert weather with meteorologist Zach Fradella.
Another usual summer day across southwest Louisiana. Some of you got wet, some of you didn't, but some of you also dealt with clouds. Even though you might have not seen the rain, you at least got the cloud cover, and that helps your temperatures. You see across the board, things have quieted down even in this early evening hour, just past, say, about 5:15. The only active weather right now is across portions of northern Vermilion Parish. It's just, say, just to the west of Abbeville, there's a heavy downpour right along Highway 35. That might slowly work towards I-10. So if you're traveling I-10, you might still get some shower activity. But we're going to go off to the north, and you can see how these areas are still baking in heat. You've really not seen any rain at all. And you see this boundary, it's one of those cool outflow boundaries that's coming down from the storms to the south. So we might pop a shower. Right now it's moving through DeRidder. You probably feel maybe a gust of wind and you probably clouded over right now. Well, you might get a little shower on the backside of that boundary. But for the most part, we're not talking about any thunderstorm activity across the Lake Charles vicinity. We had some heavy storms just across South Lake Charles about 2 or 3 hours ago, but that is all dissipated. And you can see we have all these lines all over the board. That's those outflow boundaries. And what do they actually look like in the atmosphere? Well, notice how this one, it's down south right here. I'm actually going to show it to you on Skycam. In the atmosphere, this is what it looks like. When you see this line of clouds, that's those lines you actually see on radar. But notice, the cumulus clouds, they're not really towering up in the atmosphere just yet. They need to build up to produce rain. And this one's very low in the atmosphere. That's why we're not seeing any rain underneath it. But you see the sun beating on them, so we can easily still get a shower or storm, say, across South Lake Charles or maybe farther south, closer to Cameron Parish, because that's where it looks like that boundary is kind of moving at this time. Temperatures across the board, we're still plenty warm. I would still say we're hot, especially DeRidder. You were at 91 last hour. You've dropped. That's because that boundary's moving through. You're still sitting at 89. The only real rain cool locations, say Jennings at 81, that's one rain cool location. On the east side of town, that's where we really saw the heavier downpours early this afternoon. Chenault sitting at 82, and Lake Charles still sitting at 88 degrees. But get ready, because the heat, well, it's going to be more in tune as we head into the new work week. Not so much on Monday. I think we still get a nice little scattering of downpours. Still going to keep it for about a 40% chance of that rain on Monday, but it's thereafter that rain chances quickly fall off to basically nothing. Yeah, Wednesday through Friday, we'll have a shower or two, mainly along the coast, but the bigger story, the heat. Look at those highs during the afternoon hours, 95 or 96. That's in Lake Charles right next to water. Northern locations, you might easily be 97 or 98. So I think the heat advisory is going to come back later on this week, as the heat is probably going to be the bigger story once we get into the middle to end of the upcoming work week.
Those temperatures creeping up once again. All right. Well, turning now to our weekend movie roundup, Ghostbusters couldn't bust The Secret Life of Pets from its first place spot in the box office. The Universal Studios film stayed on top
top with $50.6 million in its second week. The much-anticipated remake, though, of the 1984 hit movie Ghostbusters came in second during its opening week, bringing in $46 million. And rounding out the top three was The Legend of Tarzan, which collected just over $11 million. I have to say, I'll admit, I saw The Secret Life of Pets, and it was hilarious.
If you love animals, I think you just have to see it.
That was such a good movie. We could all go for a good comedy right now. All right, Mike, what do you have coming up in sports?
Well, coming up, we had the Sunday showdown at the British Open today between Henrik Stenson and Phil Mickelson. Well, coming up, we'll have the highlights from that, as well as NASCAR. That's all coming up next in sports.
For all your mattress needs, stop by and visit us at any one of the Mattress Joe locations, because Mattress Joe saves you money!
KPLCConnections.com, your link to Southwest Louisiana.
Get all the benefits of a new Honda, but for thousands less. During your Louisiana Honda dealer's Honda Certified Pre-Owned Sale. Every Honda Certified Pre-Owned vehicle is on sale at every Louisiana Honda dealer. Honda Certified Pre-Owned vehicles come with a 182-point inspection, an extensive certified pre-owned warranty, a free vehicle history report, and much more. With a Honda Certified Pre-Owned vehicle, you get certified reliability with serious certified savings at your tried and true Louisiana Honda dealers.
Award-winning news coverage, entertainment, and sports programming. Those are the most visible things we do at Raycom Media, but it's only part of the story.
We're technology specialists,
audience engagement managers,
and innovators on every digital platform.
We believe in sharing opportunities from within,
training and advancement while recruiting the brightest.
A team dedicated to results for our communities and our clients.
At Raycom Media, we develop leaders.
Imagine yourself here. Go to RaycomMedia.com and click on careers.
Louisiana needs a hero. Someone to look after it. Preserve it.
We have to do something now.
If everybody took care of their spot, we wouldn't have this conversation.
We all have to do our part.
The power is yours. All you have to do is pick it up. Care about it. Protect it. Save it.
Be an everyday hero.
Keep Louisiana beautiful.
We call it Southwest Louisiana, sportsman's paradise, Cajun country. Well, the names may be up for debate, but whether you're from West Calcasieu, East Beauregard, or the Cameron Coast, everyone agrees. Our proud traditions make us a certain way. It's the way we embrace our faith, community, and our heritage. That way is what unites us. It's what we call home.
Get a weather forecast that's hour by hour, anywhere, anytime, created exclusively for you. With the KPLC Personal Forecast, you'll never be caught off guard again. The 7 Storm Team Personal Forecast is sponsored by Lakeside Bank.
Where local sports come first. 7 Sports with Mike Gaither.
Yeah, now that's some serious bend to end it on 18. I only wish I could do that with my putter one day. Anyways, the Sunday showdown between Stenson and Phil Mickelson will certainly go down in Open Championship history. After 7 career top 5 finishes at major championships, Henrik Stenson broke through on Sunday, winning his first victory in style at the 145th Open Championship. Let's get straight to it. Roll the highlights and check out this little guy. He's got the best seat in the house at the Royal Troon. And let's pick it up. Phil Mickelson, he entered Sunday's final round, sitting just one shot behind Henrik Stenson here on the first hole. Great approach shot. And that is a beauty. That sets up a birdie on the first to take the lead at 12 under. Then on the second, Mickelson, tough chip shot here. And oh my, barely misses it. He saves par there. Stenson would birdie that hole, and they both would be at 12 under. Later on the 15th hole, Henrik Stenson from birdie from 51 feet out off the fringe, and he buries it to move to 18 under. He had 10 birdies on the day. To the 16th, we go a par 5, and Stenson, oh my, beautiful chip shot from the heavy rough. That sets up another birdie. He would move to 19 under. Then at the 18th, Stenson capped off his victory in style, pumping a 310-yard three-wood down the 18th fairway. Stenson hit 16 of 18 greens in regulation, and Stenson would pour in a putt to get the 20-under mark. Stenson 63 on Sunday matched the major record set by Jason Day last year at the PGA. Stenson also beat Tiger Woods' Open Championship mark of 19-under set at St. Andrews in 2000.
I felt like this was going to be my turn. I knew I was going to have to battle back if it wasn't, but I think that was the extra self-belief that made me go all the way this week. It's a dream come true as a young kid. Well, not that young, I was 11 when I started playing, but you know, it was Ryder Cup and the Open Championship. Those were the big early memories I had, so to sit there and hold this trophy is pretty amazing.
It's probably the best I've played and not won. I think that's probably why it's disappointing, in that I don't have a point where I can look back and say if I should have done that or had I only done this. I mean, I played a bogey-free round of 65. It's on the final round of a major. Usually that's good enough to do it.
And let's go racing today at New Hampshire Motor Speedway. Alex Bowman filling in for Dale Earnhardt Jr. this week. Earnhardt Jr. not racing due to concussion-like symptoms. And boogity, 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 it was a good run for Bowman, spending the day mostly in the top 15, but he suffered a blown tire, and he hit the outside wall that brought out a caution on lap 273. Then Matt Kenseth in the 20th car. He'd come on late passing Martin Truex Jr., and he'd survive a rash of cautions late for his second win of the season. And yeah, it's always fun and games when you get to burn out at the end.
Or say boogity, boogity, boogity.
Or boogity, boogity, yeah, boogity. That's my favorite part about NASCAR highlights. Erica Bivens, not a fan of it, though.
I like the
boogity,
though. I can't believe it. I like when you say it. Well, brace yourself for cuteness. We could all use it, right? What could possibly be better than a dog and a GoPro? Mo on what this schnauzer was checking out when we return.
Just announced, Chevrolet is again the number one domestic brand for quality by J.D. Power. Better than Ford, better than Dodge, better than any domestic brand. Chevy is number one, and your Lake Charles area Chevy dealers are celebrating by saving you money. Save 20% off MSRP on a great selection of new Chevrolets. That's right, save 20% off MSRP on the number one cars, trucks, and SUVs for quality. So for the highest quality domestic cars, trucks, and SUVs, come to your Lake Charles area Chevy dealers.
Welcome to Donna's Lingerie and Swimwear. With over 30 years of experience, we can help you with any of your lingerie, swimwear, or mastectomy needs. Come by and see us.
Get connected to the right business right now with KPLCConnections.com.
Come see us here at Big A Pawn, where we loan money on just about anything worth anything. We have three stores, one on Roost Street in Sulphur, one on Prion Lake Road, and one out here on 171 by the new Walmart.
Get connected to the right business right now with KPLCConnections.com.
The promise of the Seven Storm team is that everyone has access to critical information no matter where they are. And our technology gives us the power to do just that.
During a storm, we know thousands of people are depending on us for reliable information. If we can help keep you and your family safe, that makes us feel good.
Delivering potentially life-saving information is a responsibility we take seriously. And that's why we can honestly say you can rely on the Seven Storm team.
A schnauzer and a GoPro, and voila, you get an epic journey of the new downtown Lake Charles Dog Park through their perspective. Barque du Lac officially opened this weekend. Located at the corner of Ann and Mill Street, it's a dog's dream come true. We'll have more on some of the perks for dogs and their humans tonight at 10. And actually, this is my favorite part of the whole video. You see him looking, and he tries to make a break for it out of that gate, but he's going to get stopped. Watch this. Boom.
You know what we need to do? We need to put GoPros and all the people playing Pokemon Go running into each other. Now, that'd be a good video.
Now
be
we're dangerous. Sideways because dangerous. The GoPro got knocked off.
I came over to fix it, though. There
the
I am.
Schnauzer. Oh, there's Erica Bivens. There we go. We're back to the right direction. Yeah. Here's a look out of our Westlake Sky Cam. They might have a shower across northern Cameron Parish. For the most part, I think we're basically done with the heavy storms today. Some extra clouds. Probably going to make for a very, very nice sunset. So maybe get out there and enjoy it and take in, I guess, the slightly cooler temperatures.
All right. That's going to do it for us. We'll see you back here tonight at 10 for Nightcast. As always, thanks for tuning in and have a great night.